Are you worried that your doctor might be missing a structural cause for your chronic pain? Hi, I'm Dr. Andrea Furlan, and if you live with chronic pain, you may have felt frustrated, confused, or even a little bit hopeless, especially when treatments don't seem to work as expected. Today, I want to talk about something that is often misunderstood: the different types of pain. Why treating one type may not be enough. Understanding this can help you get better care and feel less frustrated. So let's talk about the fog and smoke today. Imagine this room is full of fog, which is water, not dangerous. It's just steam or vapor. It's like nociplastic pain. The fog is real. Nociplastic pain is real, but it's not a sign of danger. Now, if the room is full of fog and there is a smoke in the corner that could be dangerous and send the building on fire, it's hard to identify the smoke when there is a lot of fog in this room. That's why it's important to identify and treat nociplastic pain mechanisms. When we look at the types of pains, I mean the mechanisms of pain, there are two main kinds. The first, a structural pain. This is pain caused by something physically wrong in your body. It could be a joint problem, a muscle injury, a nerve issue. Structural pain can be nociceptive, like the pain you feel if you have an inflamed tooth, or neuropathic, which comes from nerve damage or a neurological disease. The second type of pain is more functional pain, also called nociplastic pain. This is pain that happens when your pain system becomes overactive. The nerves and the brain, they keep sending pain signals, even when the body part is okay. There isn't a new injury or damage. The alarm system itself is malfunctioning. The pain is real, no matter what the mechanism. Pain is pain. It's like the alarm of the house is going off for different reasons, but the alarm noise is the same. Many people have both types of pain at the same time, and that's where things get tricky for both patients and doctors. Here is a way to think about it. Imagine a room full of fog. Fog is harmless, it's just water. But what if there is also smoke in the room? Smoke is dangerous because it could mean there is a fire. In this analogy, nociplastic pain is the fog. It's real, but not from a structural injury. Nociceptive or neuropathic pain is the smoke. It's also real, and it usually points to a structural problem that may need treatment. If the room is full of fog, it's much harder to see the smoke. Similarly, if you have a lot of nociplastic pain, it can make it harder for doctors to detect the structural cause of your pain. If you're enjoying this video so far, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notifications button so you can be alerted when I post new videos here. This is why sometimes treatments that should work don't seem to help. For example, surgery might fix the knee problem, but pain may remain. Injections or medications that target nerve pain might help only a little. So if there is pain from a different reason and all pain signals are real, I'm trying to say that nociplastic pain can confound the other types of pains. If the doctors, surgeons, physiotherapists are treating one type of pain, let's say a tendon injury or an inflamed joint, but they ignore that there is a nociplastic pain superimposing the problem, the benefits of treating the structural pain will go unnoticed. At the end of the treatment, the person will still be feeling pain, real pain, but it is the nociplastic pain that they are still feeling. Doctors and patients may feel disappointed, even though the treatments themselves were successful in fixing the physical structural problem. So, what is the solution? The best approach is to identify and treat all types of pains at the same time. Remember, this video is not intended to provide medical advice. It is for educational purposes only. And if you have any emergency, please go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. If we only focus on the structural problem, the patient may not notice much improvement. If we only focus on the nociplastic pain, we may miss a problem that needs surgery, a physiotherapy, or a medication. Treating both gives the best chance for real relief. It's like clearing the fog so then the smoke becomes visible and can be safely removed. You might wonder, how do we identify nociplastic pain? Well, if you are a person with chronic pain, do not try to diagnose yourself. The diagnosis is very important and it requires a detailed assessment with questionnaires, history of pain, and physical examination. Now, if you are a doctor or a healthcare professional, I would like to give you a free handout that I use to differentiate, especially neuropathic from nociplastic pain. You can go to this webpage and download it today. The link is here. I will also put this link on the description of this video below. The good news is there are many ways to treat nociplastic pain. Gentle exercise, movement, pacing activities, mind-body techniques like relaxation, meditation, and breathing exercises. Cognitive approaches, including learning about how pain works in the body and the mind. Sleep, nutrition, and stress management, they all influence how sensitive the nervous system is. These strategies, they don't replace treatments for structural pain, they complement them. And when combined, patients often notice bigger improvements and feel more in control of their pain. If you have chronic pain, it is important to know your pain is real. It doesn't mean it's all in your head. Even pain caused by changes in your nervous system is just as real as pain caused by a broken bone. The key is to understand all types of pain you have. So work with your doctor to identify both structural and functional pain. When both are treated together, the chances of improvement are much higher. And importantly, everyone, the patient, the medical team, they feel more successful and hopeful. And if you want to learn more techniques on how to relieve chronic pain, including nociceptive, neuropathic, and nociplastic pain, I wrote this book for you. Here, the 8 steps to conquer chronic pain are exactly for that, to teach you what can you do to be in control of your pain, no matter what is the mechanism. If you found this video helpful, please like it or share it with someone who might benefit. Goodbye.